As a kid, I used to grow up in Afghanistan, so there were a big problem about landmines. And we used to play in between them. In the picture you can see, a kid lost his limb, so he's not losing only a part of his body, but he's also losing a lot of emotional problems, like he can't have friends because he is disabled, and so on. And worldwide, there are about 110 million landmines, and every 22 minutes, someone is killed or maimed by a landmine. And reducing them is a huge problem because they are hidden below the ground. And so there are worldwide 60 countries, and 1 billion people are at risk. So it's a massive problem. But we call it a forgotten problem because many nations or many countries, they don't have it, so they don't care about it. And this problem, it's not new. It's even from the World War I and II. And so there are many countries, and we selected here top six countries. Like in Angola, there are about 20 million. And there are 2 landmines per person. And in Afghanistan, there are about 10 million. So all these landmines, they are laid there because of many troops. For example, they came in Afghanistan to train with their guns and explosives. So usually they laid landmines to just protect themselves from the inhabitants. When they leave back, they leave also all these munitions behind, which became a huge problem. And so this is how it is done now. Demining, it works in 2 steps. A deminer walks with a stick on the ground with a detector, and he basically probably has done many weeks to clear this path. And once it rains, the grass grows back and the problem is just started again. And then clearance, and then he has to use his small tools to dig in the ground. Many of them get injured, but also they work. Many of them also are also locals. They work because they need the money, so they do also this bad work. But it's very dangerous and it's very slow. So it's mainly done with three methodologies. They are the most popular, but also cost efficient, as they say, like a dog or a rat, and a handheld metal detector. So the problem there is the range. They can't go very far. The cost, and there's always a human involved. So we want to get rid of all this and make the process much faster. So the first inspirations, they came from our childhood. So when we used to live in Afghanistan, I used to make this kind of paper models to play around. So sometimes they got stuck between the landmines. So that was our problem. And when I came to the Netherlands, so I was age of 14, and then this was one of my graduation projects at the Design Academy. So this is actually a scale-up model of the small miniatures, right? And then I thought, okay, I will make the same toy really big. It will be blown by the wind. And if it hits a landmine, it will blow itself up. So I did it. So this is one of the models. So this is an art piece, which is meant to raise awareness. So when it hits the landmine, it blows itself up. So this is a reel. This was one of my graduation projects. I spent all my student money to it, and then at the end we blew it out because it was necessary. So a lot of students, they told me, "No, man, you're crazy because now your prototype is gone." So, but it was meant for that. And then, thank you. And then I built 3 more, and a few more actually, and then we did more test sessions, and I presented around the world. It's now also collected into MoMA, Museum of Modern Art in New York, as a art piece. And so this raised a lot of attention for the landmine industry. So that was a good beginning, but it's still not the solution. So how do we solve the landmine problem? Back in 2013, me and my brother, we sit together and say, okay, this is the problem, let's solve it also. And then we came up with an idea to create a drone platform which can detect, which can map, detect, and destroy landmines from a safe distance. So if we use the traditional methodologies, which is a handheld metal detector, it will take 1,100 years. So that won't happen in our lifetime. But our methodology can reduce and get rid of landmines within 10 years. I will show you now a video, because this project is funded by the Kickstarter community. We have over 8,000 backers. So here will be a short video that how this project works actually.
Every single day on this planet, someone is injured or killed by a landmine. Removing them is very time consuming and dangerous. Millions of landmines litter the landscapes of the war-torn countries around the world. My name is Masoud Hassani and I want to change this. Our mission is to solve the landmine problems within 10 years. Now we are very excited to introduce you our newest robotic invention, the Mankafon drone. It is an airborne demining system which aims to reduce landmines in less than 10 years globally. Mankafon drone flies above a dangerous area. It generates a 3D map. Then it detects landmines with a metal detector and GPS coordinates. The drone has a robotic arm which places detonators on top of a landmine and blows them up from a safe distance. These three methodologies combined makes the Mankafon drones up to 20 times faster than the traditional technologies. It is safer and up to 200 times cheaper. Imagine if we could fly with hundreds of Mankafon drones all over the affected landscapes worldwide and free the world from landmines. With such a disruptive approach, we could save thousands of lives.
Thank you. Thank you. So then we actually started our own startup. So there are about 10 people working now there, so also international. And in previous years, we have worked with 20 plus people, also volunteers in all over the world. And we use technologies which are accessible, like 3D printing, but also open source technologies and so on. And then we implement them and improve them to make this product. So as I explained, it works in three steps: mapping, detecting, and detonation. I will go through the steps to show you exactly. So this is the mapping part. So the drone flies over an area, and then it creates such a 3D map. So here we basically reconstruct the whole area. And then we know that how this area looks like to be able to fly in this area autonomously. So here, one of our colleagues is working on his computer to analyze this area. And then we go to the detection. And then we put this in graphics into computer, and we know exactly what are the distances. And then a drone flies with a metal detector. So this was our previous model. And this works. I will show you in a GIF. So the GIF animates like it flies with a detector. The hidden landmines will be pinpointed with the GPS coordinates. And in reality, it works like this. So this is one of our drones. It has the metal detector. The metal detector goes really low on the ground. This one is meant for grass fields. And so if the metal detector hits it, doesn't matter. So here we found a landmine here. It's all wireless. And then it has also a paint mechanism. We can paint the object, also geotag it with a GPS GPS tag. And then we have the detonation part, a robotic arm which places a detonator on top of it. So it works like this. So a small drone or a small gripper puts a really tiny detonator. It's like a firework, for example. It busts the ground, and then the landmine will be blown up. Again, here how it works. So we were shooting a program for a TV, a kids program in the Netherlands. So she was pretty scared because the drone is pretty big and the wind. And here we just show like a tennis ball, that how precise you can put it. Now it was done manually, but at the end it needs to be done automatically, for example. So the differences are quite big. So as you can see, there's a person and there's a AI or a drone, you know, which can do the same work. Here, it's very important that it needs to be done safe, fast. And then at the end, the fields need to be released so people can go, like kids, they can go and play around, and also farmers, they can start their vegetations and so on. Because we as kids, we also experience all these difficulties. So here, the benefits are quite a lot because it's all autonomous. We use maps and we use the highest technologies, but for very difficult job. And so how can we deploy it? So we are an R&D company, and the guys who will use it are basically NGOs, United Nations, and some governments. And here I was presenting this to an NGO, which is MAG Advisory Group. They are based in many countries, and they are getting funding, for example, from the governments to do this work. So indirectly, every one of you probably here pays from their tax money to their government, and their government pays these people. So we care that it needs to be done fast and good. So they were very happy about this process, and I heard they're also working on similar technologies now because it's also important for them. And as I said, I've talked with 70 members of the United Nations, from ambassadors from different countries. They know about it, but they have to also push their regulations to go faster because we are running out of time. And then also it's important that also they back the project with their regulations. So worldwide, we have presented the project to many organizations and governments to convince them. And we are a small team, as I said. And this was in Dubai. We were finalists for Drones for Good competition. So from 1,000 organizations, we end up in 4. And recently, we won also the European Drone Prize. So we are kind of innovative in that thing in Europe. And then our hope is landmine without a world without landmines. And thanks for your attention. And it was a honor to be here. Thank you.